Just focus on that box, okay? So put your dots on you. It's a parallelogram. Yep. So the formula is going to be area of a parallelogram equals base times height. Well, the base is where the box touches. It touches the 20 and it touches the 12. So all you do is going to take 20 times 12. So you're going to get 240 square inches. Any questions on what I just said? All right, next. The next one, next two, are triangles. So you have to remember to divide by two. The box touches the four and it touches the three. However, we want the whole base. So you got to add the four plus the three. So basically, it's going to be four times seven divided by two. So it's one half the base times the height. So divide by two as the last step. So it touches the four, which is the height, and the base is going to be the four plus the three. You got to add that up. So you're going to get 28 divided by two, which is going to be 14 square inches. Make sure if it's a triangle, you divide by two. Any questions on what I just said? All right, the next one. The next one, the base touches the three and the two. However, this is hollow. This is not part of the triangle, so we want to use only the five. You might say, well, wait a second. You added the four and the three. Yes, I did, because that was the whole base of the triangle. However, on this one, two is not the base of the triangle. It's dotted. That means it doesn't exist. The base of the triangle is five. So it's going to be one half the base, which is 5, times the height, which is 3, where the other dot touches. So it's going to be half of 15, which is 7.5. Any questions about the differences between these two problems? Again, this one, the whole base is 4 plus 3, which is 7. However, this one, the 2, why did they give you the 2? There's no reason why they did. You don't need it. It's not part of the original triangle, but the base is 5, the height is 3. Is everybody clear on this? Okay. Put away your bell work, please. On a new sheet of paper, draw that trapezoid.
Thank you. Don't hurry up, sir.
All right, what I'm about ready to show you is going to be the easy one. The triangles and the parallelograms better be easy for you, because next Friday you have test number two. But when I get finished with this one, then we're going to get to the harder one. All of this away in second two. All right, here we go. I don't know if you have to memorize these formulas. Okay, last year they gave them to the kids. But just in case, try to memorize them. So here we go. The bases are the ones that are parallel. So if you look at this diagram of a trapezoid, the ones that are parallel are right here. Those are my bases. Some kids say, oh, it's the top and the bottom. That's wrong on this one, because those are not parallel. So, on your paper, you're going to say half of whatever. That's what that one half is. So I put a 2 on the bottom. That's the way I do it. My bases are going to be the 5 and the 20. The question now is, if 5 and 20 are my bases, which one is the height? Is it going to be the 10 or is it the 30? Does anybody know? Yes. It's got to be the 10. This one's on a slant. That's not a true height. So the height is 10. Now get your calculator out. If you don't have one by tomorrow, you will have a 5-minute detention. I'm telling you, you got to have it from this point on. I'm going to let you go today, but tomorrow I'm not playing games. We're going to walk around. You don't have it, 5 minutes. Come see me. I've got to do it because you've got to get them in. This right here is 25 times 10. So 25 times 10 gives me 250. But I have to take half of that, which is 125. This is the easy one. Okay, yes. Things. This is the easy diagram. Don't miss these. This is like Christmas in November. Right? It's a gift. Don't miss these. Seriously. We're going to try one more. Try that one on your own. Which ones are the bases? Which one's the height? Divide by 2.
Copy down the formula again.
Step one for me is always copy the diagram. And don't waste time on that.
This is going to be parallel. I want to mark your parallel sides to help you remember the bases.
Now while you're working this one, listen to what I'm going to tell you. It's going to sound a little harsh, but it's true. Some of you have been getting by with just marginal amount of effort. That's going to stop today, because the work is going to increase the level of difficulty. And if you don't believe what I'm saying, trust me, I know what I'm saying. You're going to have to really give it your full attention on these next few problems. All right, look up here. Which ones are my bases on this diagram? Does anybody know? Spencer, you know? All right. 5 and what? 5 and 10 are parallel. Good. So put 5 plus 10. And which one is my height, the 7 or the 9? The 7. Very good. Clear your calculator. Take 15 times 7. So 15 times 7. Press equals and then divide it in half. I got 52.5. Anybody else got that? All right. Put 52.5 square inches. Remember, area is two dimension. There's only three dimension. Volume is three dimension. Some people are still looking for the fourth dimension. Is everybody clear on the easy ones here? All right. Now we're going to step up to the harder one. Bless you. Draw that diagram, please. I'm sorry, you had a question?
Are you
going to
do it there? Or just go along with it?
Well, I think just let one of us do it. We don't want to distract them. We want to focus on either you or me. They might like you better because you might be prettier than me. But,
I said Halloween was over yesterday, so I had to get a haircut. That's great.
All right. Come on, get this down. And I'm going to show you why this one's harder. I usually don't take money during class. Oh, is that money?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
All right, look up here. Which ones are my bases? All right, so put 5 plus 7. Divided by 2. Where did that 2 come from? Who can tell me where did that 2 come from? Yes? Okay. Who can tell me where that 2 came from? It's in the formula. The formula is 1/2 the height times the sum of the two bases. So when I ask you where did it come from, it came from the formula. I just didn't create it. It's a formula. Somebody proved it. Is everybody with me so far? The problem here is we don't know the height. Now watch and listen. This is where it's got you're going to have to step up. Take this triangle and pull it out. Separate it.
A second triangle underneath.
Put an H right there because we need the height. Now you really have to listen. How much is this whole side right here? How much is the upper side? So what's 7 minus that 5? Well, try again. That bottom piece is 2. We pulled that triangle out. 7 minus 5 is 2. That bottom piece is 2. Everybody with me? All right, here's where it's going to get complicated. Put 60 degrees right here. That makes this one 30. This is called a 30-60-90 triangle. Write it down. It's special. Special means you need to memorize it. You must memorize it. Whenever you see a 30-60-90 triangle, in your head, you're going to have this pop up. 1, 2, square root of 3. You must memorize this. Okay, now here's the trick. And here's how we're going to do it. Put circles around the triangle. We're going to fill these circles with these numbers I'm telling you to memorize. The 1 is the smallest one. The 30 is the smallest one. So go across from the 30 and put the 1 right here.
Smallest side.
The smaller the angle, the smaller the side. Now the 2 is the biggest. You might say no. 3 is the biggest. I'm going to say no, that's not 3. That's the square root of 3, which is 1.7. Trust me, 2 is the biggest. 90 is the biggest. Go across from the 90 and put the 2. The only one left is the weird looking one. No, not me. The square root of 3. So put the square root of 3 in the only bubble you have left. All right. Now we're going to write something called an extended proportion. All my bubbles go on top. See this one? That slant? We don't need that one. So for the time being, just X that out. That's just extra stuff we don't need. Put your circles on top. So put 1 over 2 equals square root of 3 over 8. Always put your circles on top. Where did I get what? Right here. 1 over 2 equals square root of 3 over h. It's called a proportion. I had you memorize this. 1, 2, square root of 3. The 1 came from here. Memorize it. You'll see when we do more of these. But for right now, this is where we are. We're going to cross multiply. So h times 1 is just h. But here I get 2 times the square root of 3. Clear your calculator. I got to show you how to do this. I'm going to zoom in so you can see it. So I'm going to clear it out. I'm going to press the square root of 3 equals 1.7 and a bunch of other numbers. Times 2. So hit times 2, press equal. I get 3.5 approximately. Any questions on how I did my height of this trapezoid? It's a lot, okay? You probably got some questions. Hold them for now. Trust me. Just hold them. You might be there. We're going to do 2 or 3 more examples. Now I got my height is 3.5. I can finish my problem. So I put, wherever I was working this one, right here, I put my height as 3.5 because I used special triangles. Now I could finish this up and burn up 2 or 3 more minutes. I'm not going to do that. I found my height. I know I can work it. Now let's try another one. Draw this triangle right here. Make this one 7 and call this one X and Y. Now I'm going to walk you through it. Put your circles around your triangle right now
on each side.
If you're cramming this in on a little piece of paper, that's not a good thing. You should have like a fresh piece of paper because each one of these is special.
This is relearning that special triangle for the 6090.
Put your circles around it. Come on, catch up. This is what I asked you to do. I asked you to put circles here. Now I asked you to memorize for the 30, 60, 90. Does anybody remember what I asked you to memorize? 1, 2, and then what? Square root of 3. Very good. Out of these 3, which one is the biggest? The 2. So put big.
numbers that go in the circle.
Out of these three angles, which one is the biggest? Put your pencil on a 90. Come on. I'm watching. Put your pencil on a 90. Slide across and put 2. Slide across. Which one is the smallest one out of these three angles? Which one of these is the smallest? The 1. Put your pencil on the 30. Slide across and put the 1. What's the only one left? The weird looking. Again, not me. Go across from the 60 and put the square root of 3. Everybody with me so far?
The first step is labeling that special triangle.
If you put them in the wrong spot, your name can be Albert Einstein. You're going to miss it. I'm telling you, it's got to be just like this. All right, let's set up our proportions. You see how we know both of these? I always go to that one first. So put the circles on top.
There's no variable. There's no X or Y there.
So put 1 over 7. And I saved the weird one for last. So I'm going to go to this one. 2 over X. And then I'm going to do the weird one last. Square root of 3.
One side equals another side equals the third side.
If you put some circles, if you put some circles on the top and some on the bottom, you're going to miss it. You have to be consistent. Yes. Because what we're doing here is a proportion. And the 1, 2, square root of 3 actually relates to a smaller triangle. And they are proportionately equal. Proportionately equal. Okay? Now, that's the best example I'm going to give you, a reason why. Because you don't really need to know more than that. What you need to know is how to work it. But this is correct. You're setting up a proportion to a similar triangle. Now, since we know this one, this is called your scale factor. Circle these two and rewrite it. Now, you should know how to cross multiply. Please do that right now.
One cross equals the other cross. Then we'll cross the equal sign.
Finish that problem, please. Well, this is the easy one. What's X times 1? What's 7 times 2? That one was easy. Let's do the last one. Okay, the weird looking one. You would not put these two together. Why? You got an X and a Y, so forget about that one. Use these two. So put 1 over 7, which is your scale factor. Copy that in. Now cross multiply. Come on, guys. If I say cross multiply and you're not moving, you're a day late and a dollar short. You're not going to make it. You're going to have to step up. I'm going to get Y and then 7 square root of 3. Clear your calculator. I need you to do this. Clear it out. Press the square root of 3, press equals, and then times 7, and then round it off. This is going to be 12.1. Make sure you can get 12.1. Yes. Not 3 over y. It's the square root of 3. It's 1.7. Yeah. Yeah, I think I did that.
I know, but I'm saying, if you have to put another formula to the square root of 3.7.
You mean the extended proportion?
Yeah.
I just do that just as a matter of trying to explain. You don't really have to. You can just go with these two and then those two. Is that what you're asking? That's correct. Yes. All right, that's a good question. When you multiply, this one is inside the radical sign. You cannot multiply one that's outside times one that's inside. If it was written like this, the square root of 7 times the square root of 3, where they're both inside the radical, then that would be the square root of 21. But since the 7 is not inside the radical, you cannot multiply one that's in with one that's out. Does that answer your question?
Yeah.
All right, who else? All right, now it's your turn. We worked 1, we worked 2, now it's your turn. See if you can get the whole thing, okay? Let's see who's smart enough to do that. You can use your notes. Draw this triangle. And we're going to make this one right here 12. I want X and Y. Let's see who can get it now, okay? If you can't get it, don't be too hard on yourself, okay? But we're going to show you.
Draw your circles. Put what you memorize inside each circle correctly.
What's wrong with this picture? You're supposed to be writing and you're looking at me. Come on. No time distraction. I know I'm a handsome man, but you've got to be working. Put your circles. Write down what I ask you to memorize. Put them in the appropriate circle. Set up your proportions and work it out. Yeah, the circles go at the top. Mm-hmm. Right, yeah, well, not really. So here you put the 1 inside, mm-hmm. Why didn't you put the 2 inside? Mm-hmm. Alright, that's fine. But it's not 3. That's where we're going to get 1. All right, about 1 more minute. Yeah, I think you got to divide by the square root of 3 on this one. All right, here we go. Yeah, both, please. All right, look up here. What did I ask you to memorize for a 30, 60, 90 triangle? 1, 2, and then what? Square root of 3. Is everybody clear? Which one is the biggest out of these 3? Go across from the 90, because that's the biggest. If your 2 is not with that X, then you put it in the wrong spot. Which one's the smallest out of these? Go across from the 30, because the 30 is the smallest. Put a 1 right here. Look at your work. I mean, if you did that, that's good. And then the weird one goes across from the 60. Always. Always. Any questions so far? You see how we know both of these? We're going to use it here and there. So what he was saying earlier, Spencer was saying earlier, so put the square root of 3 over 12 equals 1 over y. And then set up the other one since we're setting them up. Put the square root of 3 over 12 equals 2 over x. Any questions on my setup? Is everybody with me? All right, now we're going to do the math. How much is y times the square root of 3? It's just going to be y square root of 3.
How much is 12 times 1? Come on, guys. If I ask you for 12 times 1, then you got to give me that. Divide by the square root of 3. Clear your calculator. I'm going to show you how to do that. Press 12. Divide it by. I'm going to use parentheses. Start learning how to use put parentheses. Press the square root of 3. Close parentheses. Press equals. I don't care how you do it. This is the way I'm going to do it because I know my answer is 6.9. Any questions on how I did it on my calculator? It is, but you never round it in the middle of a problem. You always round it at the very end. Okay? You'll be close, but close only counts in horseshoes and hand grenades, not in math. Okay? All right, let's go to the next one. This one's going to be x times the square root of 3 equals 24. I'm going to divide by the square root of 3. So clear your calculator. Press 24. Come on, try to keep up with me. 24 divided by, open parentheses, square root of 3, close parentheses, voila, 13.9. Now your homework is going to only be two problems, because I got to make sure you can do this. And I have them right here. You might be able to do them before you leave. Copy them down. I'm going to pause this video here and I'm going to upload it.